Namaskar and welcome again to Planet to Soul Astrology. So friends, now you can see I have prepared the board. Actually, little bit it is uncomfortable, but still I have tried that for certain topics I will definitely try to explain. You know, I can explain you on computer also by directly sharing the computer screen of Kundali or anything, but certain topics are such topics that we have to do it manually and explanation is needed very much. So today friends, we are going to talk about Indu Lagna in our chart. Indu Lagna, what is the meaning of Indu Lagna? Indu Lagna, it is a Sanskrit word, and moon or Chandra is called Indu also in Sanskrit. So females who are having Indu name, that means they are connected to moon and maybe they are very moody by nature. You know, our name consists of so many meanings, and always we have to consider whatever name has been given, this name was and is destined for us, and we have to take out some positive as well as, you know, some other meanings also which we really have to improve in ourselves. So welcome again to Planet to Soul Astrology. So friends, today I'm going to explain you about Indu Lagna. Indu Lagna, as you can see, this is wealth, prosperity and fortune. So basically what I can say here, that whenever we are trying to see wealth of a person, that what type of wealth this person will be having or what type of financial position this person will be having, whether this person's fortune will enhance or no, so that time we do consider Indu Lagna. Why only Indu Lagna? Because moon is movable, moon is always chara, and moon is always moving. It is not stable or it is not sthir at one place, it is not fixed. So it is connected to liquidity. This can be liquidity of money also, this can be liquids of our body also. That is why we say that 70% of our body is made up of water. See, so simple it is. And we always say there will be liquidity of money, there will be fixed assets, but beneath all these statements or predictions, whatever we are seeing or making in the chart, we have to see that what is the actual position of moon in this particular chart. Then comes the other planets like Venus, that whether Venus is also Shuddha or no, or pure or no. Then Jupiter, even though Venus is good in the chart, but if Jupiter is not allowing fortune to enhance, then you are not supposed to enjoy your fruits. But friends, Indu Lagna is such a lagna that whenever, even though you don't have lots of money, lots of wealth, but whenever moon passes from your Indu Lagna, or whenever the dasha, antar dasha or in transit also, benefic planets transit over your Indu Lagna planet, that time definitely your fortune is bound to expand. You are bound to get some good fruits in terms of wealth, prosperity, good news related to related to your life. And particularly whenever Indu Lagna gets activated, that time what house this Indu Lagna planet is posited, that house also gets activated, and fruits of that house also gets activated wherever the Lord is and which house is the Indu Lagna is posited. So friends, today we will learn or try to learn about Indu Lagna. So before starting, let me tell you all that for Indu Lagna, all the planets except Rahu Ketu are given particular marks or particular bindus or particular points to rule out our Indu Lagna manually. In many softwares, automatically Indu Lagna is derived and definitely you can read from it. But many of my friends, including me, who do believe in counting the things in calculations, because when you know particular things, it is not necessary that every time you have to go for this process, but it is very much necessary that you should know the roots of that particular process, that how the Indu Lagna has been derived from particular ascendant or particular chart. So friends, I have written names of all the planets, and first name, like weekdays, I have written first name of Surya, that is Sun. So Sun is holding 30 bindus. Sun is holding 30 marks. Then we will go to Moon. So Moon is holding 16 marks here. Whenever Moon is of 16 kalas, Moon is of 16 full moon, whatever we call it, or Purnima, when the Moon is most powerful, when 16 kala se Chandra khilta hai, that is why Krishna and Moon has been connected. Rohini Moon is said that all 16 kalas are included, or all 16 kalas are inbuilt in this Rohini Nakshatra. That is why Rohini Nakshatra Moon is said to be exalted in Taurus sign, because Taurus is Venus. Venus is definitely connected with Sanjeevani. Sanjeevani is also connected with wealth. Unless and until you are alive, you are Sanjeevani means making something alive. You cannot earn money or you cannot get money. Every planet is connected to each other. So Sun has been given 30, Moon has been given 16. Then we will come to Mars. So Mars is given only 6 kalas, okay, only 6 marks. Then we will come to Mercury. So Mercury is given 8 marks. Then after Mercury, Jupiter, Guru has been given 10 marks. Then comes Venus. Here by mistake I have written this, okay. So then comes Venus. So Venus has been given 12 marks. And then comes the Saturn, last one, which is given only 1 marks. As I always say, that Saturn is a low tide of materiality and high tide of reality. So least marks have been given to Saturn. That means if your Indu Lagna is Saturn, you are bound to do more and more karmas which are carried forward from your last life. Then again, it depends on your quality of Saturn in your chart. So friends, in simple terms, what you can see that after Moon. So friends, I have taken Gemini ascendant as an example chart, and let me tell you all that we have to count 9th house from your ascendant and 9th house from your moon to count the Indu Lagna. You should know this procedure so that everyone who are not aware of software, or in their software if Indu Lagna is not available, this is the easiest method I am showing. You can count your own Indu Lagna and you can see that what days and what particular phase on, and to get good prosperity and good money. So what we have to do, that from 9th house, from Gemini sign, there is a Saturn sign, okay. So what I will see, that Saturn is holding only 1 mark. So I will write only 1 mark here, and then I will put Moon here, okay. So this is Leo sign Moon. So from Moon again I have to see 9th house. So opposite is the 7th house, then 8th house, and then 9th house. So 9th house is holding sign of Aries, that is Mangal, Mars. So how many marks have been given to Mars? So 6 marks have been given to Mars. So 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. So to derive Indu Lagna, I will count 7 houses from my moon, okay. So which is the 7th house from my moon? It is Aquarius, okay. So Aquarius becomes my Indu Lagna. That means Saturn is my Indu Lagna planet. Now you will say that maybe I am getting more than 12, 30. If it would have been here, the moon, then it could have gone to 31 marks. Then what you have to do in that case, you have to divide the total. If you are getting total of 22 marks, say for example, or 31 marks. So you have to divide the total by 12. That is total 12 zodiac signs are there. And whatever is the remainder, you have to take remainder as an answer, and that remainder you have to count from your moon, Okay, so it can be anywhere, your moon can be anywhere and any answer can come. So even if I put, now I will take another example, even if I put moon in Kanya Rashi, see I am putting moon here. So if somebody is having moon in Kanya Rashi in Gemini in Ascendant. So friends, we are putting again in second example, we are putting moon in Kanya Rashi. So what same step we have to follow. So from ascendant we will see which is the ninth house. So ninth house is Saturn. So again I will take one. Okay, we have to add ninth house from moon also. So from moon, which will be the ninth house? 7, 8, 9. So from moon, ninth house is falling for Taurus sign. So Taurus sign is of Venus, we all know that. So Venus is holding 12 marks. Okay, so I'll put 12 marks here. So 12 plus 1 is 13. Now you will say that now it is more than 12 Rashis. Then how we can count? See, up till 12 we can count. After 12, if any numbers are coming, we have to divide the actual result with 12, because there is a 12 zodiac signs. Now to derive the Indu Lagna and Indu Lagna Lord, what I'll do, I will divide this 13 with 12. Okay, so 12 ones are 12, so remainder is again 1. So what we have to count? We have to count the remainder number from moon. So from moon, if I count first house, then moon only remains the first house, that is Virgo only remains as Indu Lagna here. Okay, because as we saw in previous example, so from Leo, the seventh house was Aquarius, so we took Saturn as Indu ascendant in Indu Lagna. Now here we are getting the remainder of only one. So we have to just count, because that house has to be counted. So we will just count from the same moon. So same moon, that means first house only is derived as your Indu Lagna. Now what next? What is the fruit of this Indu Lagna? So for example, if in your chart, okay, Indu Lagna is of Kanya Rashi. Kanya Rashi is of Mercury. So say for example, Mercury is posited here in 11th house, but your Indu Lagna house is 4th house. So whenever any benefic planet transit from Indu Lagna, that is from Kanya Rashi, as well as if any benefic planets are transiting from Aquarius sign, because why I am saying Aquarius? Because the Indu Lagna Lord Mercury is sitting in 9th house of the chart. So that time definitely native will experience very good fruit related to 4th house as well as related to 9th house. Whatever the transit may be, it is not necessary that transit has to be here or transit has to be here at the same time. It can be in any house. Okay, so related to 4th house, all the fruits, that means that person will have more connectivity with mother, more business ideas, because opposite house is of profession house. Then different business ideas also, as moon is already posited here in Indu Lagna house, so definitely being the second lord, this moon will also expand its quality in terms of giving good wealth, good prosperity to the native, good liquidity of money, good travels also, because moon is independently a traveler. Okay, so definitely this will create more travels, more pilgrimages also, and more enhancement of self, self-grooming also, because the another sign of Mercury is falling in the ascendant itself. Now, when it will pass from this ninth house of the chart, this benefic planets, or person is having any Mahadasha, Antardasha, or Pratyantardasha, that is sub dasha or pranadasha of this Indu Lagna or Indu Lagna Lord, then definitely ninth house will get enhanced in terms of fortune enhancement, in terms of getting good support from the family, good support from the siblings also. At the same time, we will also see that higher education, if person is trying to, then definitely higher education, good support from person's father, whatever ninth house related things are there. Along with that, this Indu Lagna Lord will enhance the prosperity. All of a sudden, person will get good gain in terms of property, in terms of money, in terms of all wealth related to family or related to his or her business or related to ninth house connectivity. Also, this person may get benefit through wife, because ninth house is sibling house of spouse. So definitely some connectivity we can match here also. Now you will say that you are talking about only benefic planet. What about malefic planets like Mars, Saturn, Rahu, Ketu transiting in your Indu Lagna or over your Indu Lagna Lord? Yes, whenever malefic planets are also transiting, but that time we cannot forget that these malefic planets may give little bit adverse effects also. But mind well, if Mars is transiting over this moon, then definitely lot of money gain, because automatically moon and Mars is one type of Lakshmi Yoga. It is one type of wealth yoga. And again, this is your Indu Lagna. Even when Mars, Rahu or Ketu or Saturn will transit, or Surya also will transit from ninth house, that time also Indu Lagna Lord will get most activated and material benefit this person will get. But if at all you are having your Indu Lagna or Indu Lagna Lord in sixth house, 8th house and 12th house, then what we can say that no fruits? No, we cannot say that, because automatically you have your prosperity count, you have your Shakti point, we can call it as, or wealth point in your 6th house, 8th house or 12th house. But in such cases, apart from material benefit, definitely this house, whenever are getting activated, you may experience some adverse fruits in terms of different categories or different signification related to these houses. So friends, we have to see it. You cannot stick to the same dicta that now my Indu Lagna or Indu Lagna Lord is activated, now definitely I will get benefits only, or definitely I will get loss also. I'll give you one simple example. Even though transit Mars, okay, even though transit Mars is transiting from 10th house of the chart, and if it is aspecting moon here in Indu Lagna, then also person may experience good gains. Okay, you have to just explore the things, you have to just make the research that what else can be derived out of this. You can go on researching the things. If you are getting good fruits, then definitely you have to follow all the good fruits, or all the research area you have to take into consideration. Likewise, any from this all planets can become your Indu Lagna or Indu Lagna Lord. No doubt that Rahu Ketu has not been given category of Indu Lagna or Indu Lagna Lord, but definitely Rahu Ketu anyway are going to transit over Indu Lagna or over Indu Lagna Lord. So definitely we have to consider fruits as per their signification and as per that house also. But definitely this is a wealth point or this is a prosperity point for you. So stay tuned with Indu Lagna and let me know how you find this video. And yes, as I always say, do subscribe my channel, do press the bell icon to get regular notifications, and very soon I will come with Navmansh Kundali, like I'll explain the Vargottama planets of Navmansh Kundali in my next video. So by that time, stay tuned with Planet to Soul Astrology, and Sabka Mangal Ho, may all be blessed. Namaste.